good. Titus 3:11. For the great grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. It teaches us to say no, no to ungodliness and worldly possessions and to be self-controlled, upright and godly lives in this present age. While we wait for the blessing hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to redeem, save us from all wickedness, and to purify for himself a people that are his very own, that are his two children, his faithful, eager to do what is good. WWJD, what would Jesus do before doing it? Titus 4:3. One time we too were foolish, disobedient, deceived, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. We lived in malice and envy, being hated and hating one another. But when the kindness and love of God, our Savior appeared, He saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of His mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit. He poured out on us generously through Christ Jesus, our Savior, by giving your sins to Him and letting them die and love, serve, follow, and being faithful to Him from this day forward. So that having been justified by His grace, we might become heirs and heirs, having hope of eternal life, L-I-F-E, with Him in His kingdom. This is a trustworthy sign, and I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. Warn a divisive person once and then warn him a second time. After that, have nothing to do with him. You may be sure that such a man is warped and sinful. He is self-condemned and in hell eternally. People must learn to devote themselves to doing what is good. Grace be with you all. Amen, amen. Marsha. Hey, it's supposed to get bad weather again. I'm supposed to go to my son's later. This summer might be a day or two late again. But like I've told you also, it's only a site. It's not a show. So, anyway, and excuse me. My doctor told me I'm allergic to a lot of stuff, so my allergies have been really bad lately. I don't know what I'm allergic to. But anyway, that goes with being light-complected. We're allergic to a lot of stuff, so excuse me there. Okay, now close your eyes and close your mind. Breathe in, breathe out, count to 10. Now who or what comes to mind? Is who or what you use here as your God? Now open your eyes. No one or thing comes before God our Heavenly Father. For He's our real true God, our Creator, and our purpose of why we're here. And everything we see and hear here, and He's our provider of life here, and He's the only way towards eternal life. So we must think of serve Him, not the things and people here. Remember that. Amen. Okay, excuse me for last week. Wow, the camera made me look horrible, but that happens sometimes. Cameras kind of make you look horrible. Anyway, it's not like the TV, you know what I'm saying? They got all those special effects and all that stuff to make you look perfect. You know what I'm saying there. Okay, anyway, this week's sermon is called Doing What Is Good. And I'm on the front porch, that's finished. My son still got his stuff here. He's been doing some art. I'm glad he's doing something. Anyway, thing is, downstairs, we got one room done. His room's down there, and there's really no room for his computer right now because we're still working on it, so. Okay, now, this week's sermon is called Doing What Is Good. Hello to everyone. Titus 3:11. For the grace of God, God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly possessions and to be self-controlled, upright and godly lives in this present age. While we wait for the blessing hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave Himself for us to redeem, save us from all wickedness, and to purify for Himself a people that are His very own, that are His true children, eager to do what is good. WWJD, what would Jesus do before doing it? So remember that, ask that question. Titus 4:3. At one time, we too were foolish, disobedient, deceived, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. We lived in malice and envy, being hated and hating one another. But when the kindness of and love of God, our Savior, appeared, He saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of His mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth, new by the Holy Spirit, whom He poured out on us generously through Christ Jesus our Savior. By giving you sense to Him and letting Him die, amen, to His cross, and being obedient and faithful to Him. So that having been justified by His grace, we might become heirs, inherit, having hope of eternal life with Him and His kingdom, amen. This is a trustworthy sign, and I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God, remembers also on money, so trusting in God as you use them here, may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. Warn a division man once, and then warn him a second time. After that, have nothing to do with him. You may be sure that such a man is warped and sinful. He is self-condemned. He'll end in hell eternally. Our people must learn learn to devote themselves to doing what is good, what is good. Grace be with you all. Amen, amen. Now, excuse me. Let's not put a pan of water on the stove. That'll help as well. My house is really dry. Doing good and bad. That's this week's children's lesson. Now, who or what comes to mind? Maybe you've done or said something wrong, maybe even told a lie, or even hide and keep secrets that are bad. But we must tell the truth about them, which is good, because lying, hiding things, and keeping secrets that are bad can hurt people, including yourself. We must keep doing good no matter how hard it may be. Doing good in the love of God and His kindness helps us to do the right things doing good for and through Him. It makes our Heavenly Father happy by being obedient and faithful to Him as His true child of God. Amen, amen. So remember that. Okay, now let's pray. Bow your heads. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses. We forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now remember, I've taught you this, okay, a while back. Even the devil believes in God, our Heavenly Father. He became a corrupt angel of God and was kicked out of heaven into hell. So we must have belief and total faith. Belief and total faith. They work together. So remember that. Amen, amen. Okay, everybody, get your Bibles out. I've kind of changed everything a little bit here. Gotta do that sometimes. I don't want my Bible lesson and stuff, my preaching, get boring, if you know what I'm saying. Okay, everybody, get your Holy Bibles out. Okay, everybody, go to Deuteronomy 13. Worshiping other gods, other gods, other gods. Okay. Oh no, what happened to my Bible? Uh-oh. Excuse me, it got ripped and some of the pages missing, so excuse me there. If a prophet or one who foretells by dreams appears among you and announces to you a miraculous sign of wonder, and that the sign of wonder which he has spoken takes place, and he says, let us follow other gods, let us follow other gods, gods you have not known, and let us worship them. You must not listen. You must not listen to the words of that prophet or dreamer. The Lord your God is testing you to find out whether you love Him with all your heart, with all your soul. It is the Lord your God you must follow, and Him you must revere. Keep His commands in Exodus 20. Obey Him, serve Him, and hold fast to Him. That prophet or dreamer must be put to death. Put to death, you'll end up in hell. Amen. Because he preached rebellion against the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, your forefathers, and redeemed you from the land of slavery. He has tried to turn you from the way the Lord your God has commanded you to follow. You must purge the evil from among you. Remember that. If your very own brother or son or daughter or the wife you love or your closest friend secretly entices you, saying, let us go and worship other gods, gods that neither you or your fathers have known, gods of the peoples around you, whether near or far, from one end of the land to the other, do not yield to him or listen to him. Show him no pity. Do not spare him or shield him. You must certainly put him to death. Well, now we pray. We pray for them. Your hand must be the first in putting him to death, and then the hands of all the people. Stone him to death because he tried to turn you away from the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, of your forefathers, of the land of slavery. Then all Israel will hear and be afraid, and no one among you will do such an evil thing again. Anyway, like I said, now we pray for the person. Stay away from that person. So remember that. If you hear it said about one of the towns the Lord your God has given you to live in, that wicked man has arisen from you and have led the people of their town astray, saying, let us go and worship other gods, gods you have not known, then you must inquire, probe, and investigate it thoroughly. And if it is true, and it has been proved, that this detestable thing has been done among you, you must certainly put the sword. All who live in that town, destination completely, both its people and its livestock. Gather all the plunderous town in the middle of the public square and completely burn. Well, like I said, now we pray for them. The town and all its plunder, and whole burnt offerings to the Lord your God. Again, like I said, we pray for them. It is to remain a ruin forever, never to be rebuilt. None of those condemned things shall be found in your hands, or the Lord will turn his fierce anger. He will show you mercy, have compassion on you, and increase your numbers, as he promised an oath to your forefathers. Because you obey the Lord your God, keep all his requirements, all his commands, the next is 20, that I'm giving you today, and doing what is right, what is right, what is right, in his eyes, amen, amen, that's what matters. Doing what's right in our Father's eyes, amen, amen, the Heavenly Father's. Okay, everybody. Jesus. He's our light and our salvation. Amen, amen. Never life born through him is in the fruit of the Spirit, loving. Never life born through him. Amen, amen. And his light will shine in you. Lamb of God. The Lamb of God has come. The Lamb of God, which means he sacrificed himself on the cross for us and our sins. The Savior is born. Because of his love. Because of his love to everyone. Amen, amen. Jesus. Born on this day. Amen, amen. Jesus. Born on this day at Christmas time. He's our Lord and our Savior. Our hearts rejoice. Amen, amen.
Our hearts rejoice.
The light of his birth. Fills us with hope. Brings peace on earth. Amen, amen, Jesus. He's born on this day. Amen, amen. Okay. I love singing praise to God, but okay. Go to Psalm 84. Psalm is like a poem or a song. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord Almighty. My soul yearns, even faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh cry out for the living God. Even the sparrow has found a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may have her young, a place near your altar. Oh, Lord Almighty, my King and my God, my God, my God, blessed are those who dwell in your house. They are ever praising you. They are ever praising you. Amen, amen. They are. His angels are ever praising him. Amen, amen. And those up there with him in heaven. Blessed are those whose strength is in you, who have set their hearts on pilgrimage. As they pass through the valley of Baca, they make it a place of springs. The autumn rains also cover it with pools. They go from strength to strength till each appears before God in Zion, where the righteous will live at the end in his holy city. Amen, amen. Remember that. Hear my prayer, O Lord God Almighty. Listen to me, O God of Jacob. Look up. Look up. Look up our shield, O God. Look with favor on your anointed one, your anointed one. There is one day in your courts than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than dwell in the tents of the wicked, the wicked, the wicked. For the Lord God is a sun and a shield, a sun and a shield. The God bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those who walk as blameless, who walk as blameless, blameless. Oh, Lord Almighty, blessed is a man who trusts in you, who trusts in you. Amen, amen. God trusts in him through our trials and tribulations here and do the right things. Amen, amen. Through our trials and tribulations, do the right things. Amen, amen. Okay, go to... Jeremiah 10. Go to Jeremiah 10. God and idols. Hear what the Lord says to you, O house of Israel. This is what the Lord says. Do not learn the ways of the nations. The nations will be terrified by signs in the sky, though the nations are terrified by them. For the customs of the people are worthless. They are worthless. They cut a tree at a forest, and the craftsman shapes it with his chisel, including money and credit cards comes from a tree. Remember that if you worship it here. And the craftsman shapes it with chisel. I think I read this last week, but oh well. I'll read again. They adorn it with silver and gold. They fasten it with a hammer and nail so it will not toddle. Like a scarecrow in a mountain patch, their idols cannot speak. They must be carried, amen, amen, they must be carried, that's right, because they cannot walk, they cannot walk. Do not fear them. They can do no harm, nor can they do any good. No one is like you, O Lord. You are great, and your name is mighty in power. Who should not revere you, O King of the nations, this is your due among all the wise men of the nations. In all their kingdoms, there is no one like you. They are all senseless and foolish. They are all senseless and foolish. They are taught by worthless wooden idols, such as money and credit cards or wooden idols. Hammer, silver is brought from the Tarash, and gold with Aprach. What the craftsman and goldsmith have made by man. Is this dressed in blue and purple and made by skilled workers? But the Lord God is the true God. But the Lord God is the true God, true God. He is the living God, the eternal King. When he is angry, the earth trembles. The nations cannot endure his wrath anger. Tell them this. These gods that you love, serve, and follow here, who did not make the heavens and the earth, will perish, die, and in hell. From the earth and from the under the heavens, the God made the earth by his power. He formed the world by his wisdom and stretched out the heavens by his understanding. When he thunders, the waters in the heavens roar. He makes clouds rise from the ends of the earth. He sends lightning with the rain and springs out of the wind from his storehouses. Everyone is senseless and without knowledge. Everyone is senseless and without knowledge, without knowledge. Every goldsmith is shamed by his idols, 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 idols. By his images are a fraud, fake, pretend one. They have no breath in them. They are worthless, the object of mockery. When their judgment comes, they will perish, die, and in hell. He who is the portion of Jacob is not like these. For he is a maker. He is a maker of all things, of all things, of all things. For he is a maker of all things, including Israel, the tribe of his inheritance. The Lord Almighty is his name. Gather up your belongings to leave the land, to leave the land. You who live under sea, time I will hurl out and those who live in this land, and this land, and this land. I will bring distress on them so that they may be captured. Woe to me because of my injury. My wound is incurable. Yet I said to myself, this is my sickness, and I must endure it. My tent is destroyed, and all its ropes are snapped. My sons are gone from me, and are no more, and are no more, and are no more. No one is left now to pitch my tent, or to shape up my shelter, or set up my shelter, excuse me. The shepherds are senseless and do not inquire of the Lord, so they do not prosper, and all the flock is scattered. Listen, the reporter is coming, the report is coming. A great commotion from the land of the north. It will make the towns of Judah desolate, a haunt for jackals. I know, O Lord, that a man's life is not his own, is not his own. It is not for a man to direct his steps. Correct me, Lord, but only with justice, not in your anger. Lest you reduce me to nothing, pour out your wrath, anger, on the nations, that do not acknowledge you, on the peoples who do not call on your name. For they have devoured Jacob. They have devoured him completely and destroyed his homeland. Amen, amen. Oh, go to 11. This is the word that came from to Jeremiah, prophet from the Lord. Listen. To the terms of this covenant, and tell them to the people of Judah, which is everyone, and to those who live in Jerusalem, which is everywhere. Tell them this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Cursed is the man who does not obey the terms of this covenant, the terms I commanded your forefathers when I brought them out of the land of Egypt, out of iron smelting furnace. I said, obey me, and do everything I command. You will be my people, and I will be your God. Then I will fulfill the oath I swore to your forefathers, to give them a land flowing with milk and honey, the land you possess today. I answered, amen, Lord. The Lord said to me, proclaim all these words in the towns of Judah, which is everywhere, and in the streets of Jerusalem, which is everywhere. Listen to the terms of this covenant, and follow them from the time I brought your forefathers out of the land, up from Egypt, until today. I warned them, and again, saying, obey me. But they did not listen or pay attention. Instead, they followed the stubbornness of their evil hearts. So I brought on them all the curses of the covenant I had commanded them to follow, that they did not keep. You do not keep. Then the Lord said to me, this is a conspiracy among the people of Judah, which is everywhere, and those who live in Jerusalem. They have returned to the sins of their forefathers, who refused to listen to my words. They have followed other gods to serve them. Both the house of Israel and the house of Judah are broken the covenant I made with their forefathers. Therefore, this is what the Lord says. I will bring on them a disaster they cannot escape. Although they cry out to me, I will not listen to them. The towns of Judah, which is everywhere, and the people of Jerusalem, will go and cry out to the gods to where they burn incense of who or what you use here as a god. But they will not help them at all when disaster strikes. You have as many gods as you have towns. You have as many gods as you have towns, O Judah. And the altars have set up burnt incense to the shameful god Baal. which are fake gods, or as many as the streets of Jerusalem, which is everywhere. Do not pray for this people, nor offer any plea, a petition from them, because I will not listen. Listen, when they call to me in the time of their distress. What is my beloved doing in my temple as she works at her evil schemes with many? Can consecrated meat avert your punishment when you engage in your wickedness? Then you rejoice, the Lord calls you. A thriving olive tree with fruit beautiful in form, but with the word of the mighty storm, he will set it on fire. And its branches will be broken. The Lord Almighty planted you. The Lord Almighty planted you. Has decreed disaster on you. The house of Israel, which is ever, the house of Judah, have done evil. You have done evil. And provoked me to anger by burning incense to Baal, which are other gods you left and follow here. Because the Lord revealed this plot to me, I knew it. For at that time, he showed me what they were doing. I had been like a gentle lamb led to be slaughtered. I did not realize they had plotted against me, saying, let us destroy the tree and its fruit. Let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name be remembered no more. But, O Lord God Almighty, you who judge righteously, he judges righteously, remember that. And test, T-E-S-T, the heart. And mind, he tests our heart and mind. Let me see your vengeance upon them, for to you I have commended my cause. Therefore, this is what the Lord says about the men of Aruch, which is everywhere, who are seeking your life. And saying, do not prophesy in the name of the Lord, or you will die by our hands. Therefore, this is what the Lord Almighty says, I will punish them. Their young men will die by the sword, their sons and daughters by famine. Not even a remnant will be left to them, because I will bring disaster on the men of Ephrath in the year of their punishment. Amen. So remember that. Romans 1. Amen.
joy. Coming through the Spirit is peace, love, and joy. Praise His holy name. Romans 1. Paul, a servant of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God, the gospel he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, regarding his son, who to his human nature, near human nature, was a descendant of David, and who through the Spirit of holiness was declared with power to be the Son of God, our Heavenly Father, by His resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord, through Him and for His name's sake, we received grace and apostleship. Remember that grace and apostleship to call people from among all the Gentiles to the obedience that comes from faith, F-A-I-T-H. And you are among those who are called to belong to Christ Jesus. Excuse me. To all in Rome who are loved by God and called to be saints righteous, grace and peace to you from God the Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. First, I thank my God through Christ Jesus for all of you, because your faith has been reported all over the world. Amen, amen. God, whom I serve with all my whole heart, and preaching the gospel of His Son, is my witness how consistently I remember you in my prayers at all times, and I pray that now, at last, by God's will, the way may be open for me to come to you. I long to see you so that I may impact to you some spiritual gifts is in 1 Corinthians 12 of the spiritual gifts, to make you strong. That is, that you and I may be mutually encouraged by each other's faith. I do not want you to be unaware, brothers, that I planned many times to come to you, but have been prevented from doing so until now, in order that I may have a harvest among you, just as I have had among the other Gentiles. I am obligated both to Greeks and non-Greeks, both the wise and the foolish. That is why I am eager to preach the gospel also to you who are at Rome. I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes. First for the Jews, then Gentiles. For in the gospel, righteousness from God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith, from first to last. Just as it is written, the righteous will live by faith. The righteous will live by faith. Remember that. The wrath, the anger of God is being revealed from heaven against all the godlessness. Against all godlessness and wickedness of man who suppress the truth by their wickedness. Since what may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them, for since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, divine nature have been clearly saying, being understood from what he has been made so that man are without excuse. For although they knew God, they neither glorified him as God nor gave thanks to him. But their thinking became futile, and their foolish hearts were darkened. Although they claimed to be wise, they became fools and exchanged the glory of the immortal God for images made to look like mortal man, use people as a god, and birds and animals and reptiles, etc. Therefore, God gave them over to the sinful desires of their hearts, to sexual impurity, for the degrading of their bodies with one another. They exchanged the truth of God for a lie, L-I-E, and worship and serve created things, rather than the Creator, which is God, our Heavenly Father, who is forever praised. Amen. Because of this, God gave them over to this shameful lust, that's what it is, lust, L-U-S-T. Even their woman exchanged natural relations for unnatural ones in the same way. The man also abandoned natural relations with woman and were inflamed with lust, L-U-S-T, for one another. Men committed indecent acts with other men and received in themselves a due penalty for their perversion. Furthermore, since they did not think it worthwhile to retain the knowledge of God, he gave them out to a depraved mind to do what ought not to be done. They have become fulfilled with every kind of wickedness, evil, greed, and depravity. They are full of envy, murder, strife, deceit, and malice. They are gossipers, slanderers, God-haters, insolent, arrogant, and boastful. They invent ways of doing evil. They disobey their parents. They are senseless, faithless, heartless, and ruthless. Although they know God's righteous decree that those who do such things serve death, hell, they do not only continue to do these very things, but also approve of those who are practicing them. Amen. So remember that.
Hope you're having a great Sunday. I'm Janine.
Okay, excuse me. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses. Amen.
Jingle all the way on WCIC.
Okay. Let's see here. I didn't mark this. Excuse me for a second. Okay, I want to be sure I'm reading the right one. Titus 3. This week's sermon is based on remind the people to subject to rulers and authorities, to be obedient, to be ready to do whatever is good, to slander no more, to be peacemakers and considerate, and to show true humanity towards all men. At one time, we too were foolish, disobedient. Excuse me, I was supposed to read Titus 2, wasn't I? Excuse me, I didn't mark my Bible properly. No, Titus 3. Okay. Okay, where am I? Excuse me. One time we too were foolish, disobedient, deceived ones, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. We live in malice and envying, being hated and hating one another. But when the kindness of the love of God, our Savior, appeared, he saved us not because of righteous things we had done, but because of his mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us generously through Christ Jesus, our Savior, having the hope of eternal life with him in his kingdom. This is a trustworthy sign, and I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God, may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. These things are excellent and profitable for everyone. But avoid foolish controversies and generosities and arguments and quarrels about the law, because these are unprofitable and useless. Warn a divisive person once, and then warn him a second time. After that, After that, have nothing to do with him. You may be sure that such a man is warped and sinful. He is self-condemned and in hell. As soon as I send Acrasaurus to you, do your best to come to me at Necros, because I have decided to winter there. Do everything you can to help Zenas, Aloy, and Apollos on their way and see that they have everything they need. Our people must learn to devote themselves. Doing what is good in order they may provide daily necessaries and do not live unproductive lives. Everyone with me sends you greetings. Greet those who love us in the faith. Grace be with you all. Amen, amen. Okay, well, I'm missing my camcorder, so I think I might have missed this Bible verse. Excuse me if I did. I was thinking I was supposed to read Titus 1, but maybe not. Excuse me. Okay, well, maybe not. Okay, well, anyway. All right, now remember, number one, let's follow me, being faithful to God, Heavenly Father. Number two, love and take care of your personal family, your spouse and children. Number three, comes to work 40-50 hours a week. Number four, comes to two friends, my number one purpose from organizations, preach the gospel, the real God's truth. Number two, is help people. Number three, is help make our cities and state a better, safer place to live. I've emailed Governor Bruce Rohn on some issues such as to enforce motorcycle helmets for their safety and to shut down nuclear power plants and replace them with solar panels and wind turbines for our state safety and Peoria needs Peoria on some issues. I reserved a room at the Peoria's main library for a support group for stress, etc. We'll start out on meditation. That's a good one for relieving stress. Anyway, it's in the community room on December 17th, which is this Saturday, and January 7th from 12 noon to 1:30 p.m. I'll be providing drinks and a snack. Hope to see you there. If it goes well, I'll have it every month. And eventually have a fundraiser in the auditorium. It's a large room. Sing, have a concert, etc. for it, invite Governor Bruce Warner to speak, etc. And we'll be taking donations from our organization. I've also written to the president. He's written me back about 3 years ago. And I've gotten the People's Crossing signed up at the gyms for their safety about 3 years ago through Peoria's City Council. And on my multifamily house, we've been putting up plastic over the windows since my house is on a hill. I have new windows, but we can still feel the wind, cold air through them, so it'll help a lot. It's been cold out, so be careful, and it's the holidays. There's unsafe drivers out there, so be cautious. I'm finished with my Christmas shopping. I want to thank the Riverplex for my social, mental, and physical health. It is appreciated. Now remember, I've been teaching you 2 Peter 2, for a man's slave to whatever has mastered you, you are a slave to. And Christ is chosen, anointed, apostles, prophets, high priests. Christ is coming again at the end of time. And on Mount Zion, where us righteous will live with him in his holy city forever. His kingdom and discipling, James 2. That faith and good deeds and actions work together. And your faith is made complete by what you do. To those by persistent doing good, see glory, honor, and immortality. He, God, Heavenly Father, will give eternal life with him in his kingdom. And be careful by and from people who do witchcraft, murmurers, harlots, raiders, swindlers, mutilators of the flesh, debauchery, scoffers, delusions, mockers, jackals, rebels, and liars. And in 2 Peter 3:16, people who are ignorant do other scriptures besides the Holy Bible to their own destruction, which is hell. Now I have my EIN and DUNS number for my organization. I'm applying for a 501c3 Wow, there's a lot of paperwork there. It's thick, and I've got paper cuts in my hand filling it out because it's the razor sharp. Anyway, and there's more grants with it, and for a grant to help our cities for my organization, it's due next year. I'm finally getting my first novel off to the publisher. My oldest son finally came over and finished copying it, etc., that the publisher needed on my site. You can download some of my songs. I'll have more soon, like I've told you before. My oldest son just got married, has 2 part-time jobs, and my mom's dying of terminal cancer. I reminded him yesterday there's 2 professional song videos. Just go back on my sermons over a year ago. You'll see them. Just click on them and you can see and hear them. And at the beginning of Sermon 180 is another one. I'll try and have another one soon. And for donations, if you do, thank you and God bless you for it. If you don't have a PayPal account, there's another place to donate. Now pray for Nigerla, or something like that. I can't pronounce it. Church collapsed. It was under construction. 160 died, 10 injured for the families and victims. Tennessee's wildfire that forced thousands to flee that are sheltered for the victims. Columbia plane crash, 71 killed, 6 survived for the families and victims. New Zealand's quake, at least 2 dead and 1,000 stranded from a few weeks ago for the families and victims. I haven't heard the latest on it. East Coast hurricane from weeks ago, 3,400 sheltered and 1,000 died for the families and victims. My mom, Gertrude, she has terminal cancer. Dan, Margarita, Pastor Dice, Jerry, and David, they have health problems. John, Heather, Donald, and his 21-year-old daughters, they're going through something personal. Our president is out of work and caring for our country. Rulers of our state and cities, policemen and women, firemen and women, servicemen and women, pray for each other. I'm praying for you all, for my health, organization, songs, and novels I've written. Sung and writing and singing. Excuse me on my song. I only had 1 day on it too, so excuse me there. And remember, I told you this, but it's also for the newcomers. I should be dead 3 times. Twice I had cancer, once I had a near-death experience. The last time I had cancer, I've got down my hands and knees. I've cried, fasted, meditated. I even screamed. I've completely given myself, submitted myself to Him, God, our Heavenly Father, for days. Then my tumors disappeared. I've made Him a promise, God, our Heavenly Father. I have a binding contract with Him to tell the real God's truth. And when I had a near-death experience, I've seen both heaven, Jesus, and hell, the devil. So there really are both places. So who or what you love, serve, follow, here is your God, is where you're going to end. Between heaven, life with God, our Heavenly Father, eternally, or hell, suffering to burn eternally. You mean amen, so remember that, okay? Anyway, being light-complected, I also want to tell you this. We are allergic to a lot of stuff, so excuse me. I have allergies a lot. Anyway, now may the love, peace, joy, and righteousness of God be with you all. Merry Christmas. God bless you, and thank you.